श्री जी साहब संजय वर्मा साहब पधार चुके हैं और हम कार्यक्रम की आज की सुहानी सुबह की शुरुआत करेंगे ध्वजारोहण से। आमंत्रण संजय वर्मा साहब का।
अपना घर जब भरा भरा लगता है तो इट्स अमेजिंग मोमेंट। थैंक यू फॉर बीइंग हियर। आई विल बिगिन द फॉर्मल पार्ट ऑफ द प्रोग्राम बाय रीडिंग एक्सर्प्ट्स फ्रॉम द मैसेज ऑफ द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इंडिया डिलीवर्ड ऑन द ईव ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस डे। 64वें स्वतंत्रता दिवस की पूर्व संध्या पर मैं भारत और विदेशों में रह रहे अपने सभी भारतीयों को हार्दिक अभिनंदन करती हूँ। मैं हमारी सीमाओं की रक्षा कर रहे सशस्त्र सेनाओं और अर्धसैनिक बलों के वीर जवानों के साथ साथ केंद्रीय तथा राज्य स्तर के पुलिस तथा आंतरिक सुरक्षा बलों का भी विशेष रूप से अभिनंदन करती हूँ। मैं देश के प्रत्येक नागरिक का भी अभिनंदन करती हूँ जिनकी कड़ी मेहनत, उत्पादन, कुशलता और उद्यमशीलता ने भारत को विश्व के अग्रीय देशों की श्रेणी में शामिल कर दिया है। Every year we celebrate our Independence Day with great fervor as well as joy and justifiably so, as it commemorates the day when after many years of subjugation our country gained its freedom. Under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi, our movement for attaining freedom through Ahimsa and Satyagraha spread throughout the country, inspiring people in a manner rarely seen. As citizens of free India, we must reflect on the values and principles which were in the minds and hearts of those who fought and sacrificed for our freedom. Dear citizens, we are at a historic phase when the world is shifting course. It is impacting our economy, polity, trade, commerce, education, and pace of life. In this era of transformation, India definitely cannot lag behind. Our entire effort must be to ensure that there is overall development in which all people prosper. Our past and our future are linked. The future beckons us and the past guides us. Swami Vivekananda spoke of India as the ancient land where wisdom made its home before it went into any other country. From early times, India always looked at progress and moral growth as mutually inclusive rather than mutually exclusive concepts. India's depth of thought was matched by its material prosperity. We are the inheritors of this great civilization whose legacy has been passed on from generation to generation. We can be worthy heirs if we follow in the true sense the ideals of political, social and economic justice. Lip service will not do. We have to be ardent adherents. We are also duty bound to pass on the rich inheritance to our younger generation, the 540 million youth. We place great hope on them, and rightly so. They have been demonstrating their capabilities and strengths in various fields of human activity in India and abroad. Whether in multinational business enterprise or the IT industry or financial organizations or global scientific bodies, young Indians are joining their ranks and making their mark. In sports, they have been bringing laurels to the country. Our youth are the architect of the nation's future. We must educate them and inculcate in them a spirit of sacrifice, dedication, patriotism, and service to the nation. Jai Hind.
कुछ दिनों पहले दुबई के अल सुफा रोड पर एक कार एक्सीडेंट में 6 गाड़ियां आग की लपटों में झुलस गई थी, मगर एक जाबाज भारतीय ने अपनी जान दांव पर लगाकर आग की लपटों में कूटकर उसमें अपने आप को झुलसा करके कई जानों को बचाया है. A big pat and a small felicitation to the man whose name coincidentally has a very familiar ring to it, familiar sound to it. I'll call Abul Kalam Azad.
On the community's behalf and on behalf of the consulate, we will give him a letter of felicitation and a small gift.